In the last video, we have seen the process of osmosis and some daily life applications. And in this video, let us see how this can be connected to the current and in an absolute intuitive way. So welcome to my channel, Hangover Theories. There are two blocks in front of me, A and B. And these red dots represent the electrons. A have so many electrons and B have very less number of electrons. And now can you guess which is highly potential or which block has high potential? And the answer is absolutely not A, because more the positive, higher the potential. A has more number of electrons, that means less positive. And B has less electrons, that means high positive nature. So that's why we can say B is at high potential. These two blocks A and B are isolated, that means no charge can be transferred internally like in the osmosis. So for the transfer of the charge, I am connecting a conductor, that means which allow the charge to pass through it. That's what the definition of the conductor is. And the universe works in this way. It always wants the things to be stable and uniform. That's what the osmosis does. Here also the same thing happens. The charge flows from A to B until both the boxes have the same amount of charge. So A has high amount of electrons and B has very less number of electrons. And obviously the electrons will flow from block A to block B until the concentration becomes uniform. That means equal number of electrons on both the blocks. As I already said, B is having high potential, so I will be marking it as plus. And A is at low potential, that's why I have marked it as negative. We know the flow of charge is current, but by now you might be getting a doubt that why have I shown current direction from negative to positive while it is really in the reverse way in the textbooks. In a nutshell, simply, it was just because of a overlook in the observation. They thought electrons are moving from positive to negative. Later they found the reality that the electrons are moving from negative to positive. But by then there were so many books penned down showing that the current direction from positive to negative. So they came up with a different solution. They have named the two directions. They called the direction showing negative to positive is natural current, that is the electron current, that is the direction in which the electrons flows, and the direction showing from positive to negative is conventional current. But due to our tendency of laziness, we are still calling this positive to negative direction as current rather than calling it as conventional current. Coming back to the discussion, what happens if there is any break in the circuit, rather if there is any break in the conductor? Will the electrons start flowing from A, reach the tip and wait for the connection? No, they won't even start from A. Unless there is a short circuit or connected path, the charge doesn't even start moving from their place. Here the electrons are moving from A to the B to make the concentration of electrons uniform, right? But the electrons are being transferred simply, they are not being used. And by now you might have guessed that it is a simple battery. This is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal. And I want to use the energy in the electrons. I simply connect an electric bulb in the circuit. And now let's see what happens. Still, this is a connector circuit, closed circuit, because the black wire is the copper and the red thing is the tungsten filament inside the bulb. And they both combinedly forming a closed circuit. That's where the electron will start to move from A to B, and this is the path, this is the direction in which the electron starts to flow. Now what happens is, this bulb kidnaps the electrons and uses their charge to glow, and each electron has the charge 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs, as we have meters and centimeters as units for the length and kgs for mass. In the same way, we have coulombs as a unit for the charge. As we already said, B is the high potential part and A is the lower potential part. This difference in the potential is called the potential difference, or we can also say it as voltage. And we also have one more definition for this. That is the work done by the charge to move from this point to this point. That means work done per unit charge is called voltage. To understand about voltage and current more clearly, let's make a water tank analogy. I have taken four cases. In the first case, just by observing, you can say that there won't be any water flow because the tank is at bottom and tap is at upper side. So there won't be any water flow from down to up, right? And coming to the second case, there may be a chance that water will flow, starts flowing simply, we can say. And coming to the third case, water will start flowing slowly, right? Water will start flowing slowly. And coming to the fourth position, there is a very huge height difference between the land surface and the tank. So here the water flows at very fast rate, faster flow, simply we can make this. And in the third case, water flows slowly. And you can, by the common sense, we can understand that as we increase the height, when the height difference between the tap and the tank is less, the water will flow very slowly. As you increase the height difference between the tap and the tank, the water starts flowing very fast. From this example, we can connect the analogy to the electrical terms. Here the height of the tank is the voltage, water is the charge, and speed of the running water is current. As you increase the height of the tank, the speed of the running water will increase. So I can also say that as you increase the voltage, the current will increase. Mathematically, we can write it as V proportional to I. So V is the voltage and I is the current. While we observe the electrical terminology, mostly we can see the symbols will be the first letter of the word. Voltage V, and for the power we have P, and for the resistance we have R. And like this, for the most of the electrical terms, we have the first letters as their symbols. But coming to the current, it is not the C, but it is I, just because they studied this current as the term intensity of electricity. So this is how the scientist has termed initially. So this I came from the intensity of electricity. Coming back to our expression V proportional to I, and we usually see that V is equal to R into I, and they will say this R as resistance. Mathematically, we can call it as proportionality constant. And so many people will have a doubt what exactly this proportionality constant is. So we are going to discuss about this with a very small example. Proportionality symbol has a meaning that as the voltage increases, the current increases. That's what it is called, directly proportional. If the voltage decrease, the current decrease. If the voltage increase, the current also increase. This is called the directional proportional. And if it is going in the opposite way, it is called inversely proportional. Let's say you have gone to a supermarket to buy some pens. And we can simply say that the bill generated will be directly proportional to the number of pens you purchased. That means when the number of pens you purchased increases, the bill generated will also be increased. When the number of pens are less, the bill amount will also less. That's why we can say they are related as directly proportional. Let's say you have bought 2 pens and the bill generated is 10. And when the number of pens is 5, the bill amount is 25. And the number of pens is 6, the bill is 30. And for the 8 pens, the bill will be 40. But mathematically, we can't write it as 10 proportional to 25 proportional to 5, 30 proportional to 6, and 40 proportional to 8. And there is no sense in this representation. What exactly we can understand by 10 proportional to 2? What exactly we can understand is 25 proportional to 5. There is no sense in this representation. it becomes more sensible if we have equal to. But if I am placing equal to, it is going to be much more blunder, right? I have to multiply some number to make it as equation. So to make it as equation, I have to multiply 5 here. I have to multiply 5 here, also 5, and here also 5. Now this equation have some sense rather than having proportional symbol. But what exactly we are doing? To replace a proportional symbol with equal to, we had to multiply a number on the right side, and it had turned up to be a same number in all the cases. The number is not being changed. It is the same 5 being multiplied in each and every case. That's why it is called constant. That's how we got proportionality constant. And in this case, V proportional to I can write it as V equal to, we got to know that we have to multiply a constant, and this is R in this electrical case, and this R is the resistance. Coming back to our simple circuit, now we have a switch connected in series with the bulb. When I on the switch, the bulb will glow. Usually we think that right immediately we on the switch, the bulb glows, so that the speed of the electron might be around the speed of the light, or else you can think it as very very high. But practically the speed of electron is less than the speed of, can you guess, speed of a snail. Exactly, the speed of an electron is less than the speed of a snail. And again, how it make the bulb glow so fast right immediately I on the switch? So I am saying the speed of the electron is very less compared to the speed of the snail. And again, we can see that when I on the switch right immediately, the bulb will glow. How can it be happened? So in the next video, we will be discussing clearly about this fact with a simple mathematical proof by taking a 1 cm length copper wire, and we will calculate the speed of the electron in that. Thank you guys. Please like,